Hi, I'm Lottie Smith and I'm here with Little Inventors to teach you some basic skills for modelling with cardboard. First up, scoring, which is a method in order for you to bend cardboard in a certain way. So if you'd like to create a bending cardboard and you just try and do it with your hands, it'll bend like this and it's not always in a very good straight line. So the best way to get around this is if you use a ruler. So if you just like to grab a pencil and you draw a line where you'd like your bend to be in the cardboard. So once you've got your line like this, if you use a ruler, hold it along the line, get your scissors and make sure they're nicely closed. You can also use a pencil for this, but if you very carefully push down along the line, and what you're doing is you're not really cutting through, but you're just pushing it down a little bit like this. Then you can use it to fold on the line. The easiest way of doing this so it works properly is if you hold the ruler down and then lift up into the bend like that. And there you can see you've got a really nice straight line bend. It's best to bend into the line that you've pushed, because if you bend it away like that, then you get this rough edge, which sometimes you don't want, but sometimes it's useful. If you don't have a ruler, you can use anything with a straight line, like maybe a book. Next up, there's a good technique for adding strength. Sometimes when you're making stuff with cardboard, you'll have a piece and you'll make a wall with it and then you'll attach something and it bends down. And sometimes you don't want it to bend down. So if you're having trouble with that, what we can do is add two layers of cardboard together. If you line up the two pieces of cardboard so that the lines on the cardboard are running in the same direction and you put them together, they'll still bend. But if you turn one around so that the lines are cross-hatched, that's what we call this, and try and bend them, you'll find that it's a lot harder for them to bend. So just me holding these two things, it doesn't sound very useful, but when you get making on your bigger makes, it comes in handy if you remember this little tip.